It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune Crypto. I am your host, Ben. Now let's dive in. Bitcoin rebounding nicely, pushing over that 48,000. Looking very bullish right now as this candle is pushing above the red candle. This is a nice bullish signal. I would say we probably will see 50,000 maybe tonight, but probably more likely Friday. I'm thinking we may consolidate for a day in the 48 to 49 and a half area before we see a push up over the 50K. But Bitcoin looking very good right now. Ethereum looking very good as well. 10-day crossing the 50 right here. And we've pushed over 35, still pushing up to 36. Rebreaking at 35 was very important. So Ethereum's looking bullish again, getting over all of that resistance through there. As long as it can hold above that resistance, which right now looks like it's going to push up some more, and there's some room still on the RSI. So we'll probably see it on up to 37 tonight, maybe 38 if it really starts getting a lot of attention, but looking pretty good there. Cardano has rebounded some. It did pop over 250, but not able to hold so far. It's testing right now, so it needs to start holding above 250 if it's going to push up anymore. But it will get hung up again at 275, even if it does break there. Has pretty good support where it's at now, though. 10 days right there across that 200 days, so probably get a bounce. We'll probably see the break at 250. Top gainer today, REN. This one started climbing up a couple of days ago, but it's had a nice push over a dollar for a dollar break, up to $1.15. If it can hold a dollar as support, I expect a pullback here to the dollar area. But if it can bounce off there, we should see it make a nice move up after that. And we also have ORN popping up. This is one I was kind of watching, but still wasn't sure about yet. And it did have a nice break here. The pattern was pretty ugly around the 4 hour, but it did break over that area of resistance, that $10 that's been struggling with, and pushed almost up to 13. Currently consolidating a little bit below 12. A very nice move there. ALGORAND still holding a dollar. You can see still at the bottom of this uptrend. It needs to start pushing up off of $2 here. If it does not start pushing tonight off of $2 and it drops any lower, it could get a little sketchy. We could see a pullback on ALGORAND, probably to $1.75. Cosmos Atom still just consolidating in this 33-34 area. It's held it up nicely so far. With everything coming back bullish, Bitcoin and Ethereum, I certainly expect there could be another leg up on Cosmos Atom and all those coins in that ecosystem. So Avalanche breaking up and over this downtrend, running up to almost 60, got up to about 58.5, but now that downtrend's broken, it's testing right here. This previous tip looks like it's going to try to break through it. If it breaks through that, basically if it breaks 60, then it should make another leg up, looking pretty good. It's also a lot of holders of Avalanche. I looked that up on Livecoin. CGLD did get a little pop out of that little sloping channel like we've seen multiple times, but not a very good one. Got pushed right back down. It is holding a 50, so it just needs buying volume to push it back up at the moment. Just kind of light on volume, so we'll see there. This is not pretty, though. It could sell off. That's pretty ugly candles, but this thing is so volatile, it's hard to tell right at this second. So Dogecoin still hanging in there. It did get way down there to 22, which was, I was really concerned about it. Still not really rebounded at all. I mean, it's looking like stair steps down. So if it doesn't break over 25 cents again and hold 25 cents, and it gets rejected here, we could see another step down for Dogecoin. So be aware of that. Polkadot still consolidating, holding up 36. If it holds up here for a little bit longer, we'll see it probably push up to 40, make another leg up. If not, it'll drop down to the 50 at that 33 area. Farm still slowly pushing up, testing this 212, 215 area of resistance and the 50 day. You may see a breakout here soon on farm. I may start looking for a position if it can hold this area right here. Still holding my fetch swing, looking for that break over a dollar. It's been consolidating nicely, getting tighter and tighter. Looks like it's about to pop, and I'm expecting it because it is on an uptrend to pop to the upside and probably make a new high. HBAR having a little rejection at 5.5, just pulling back to the 10-day. If it can hold that 10-day at 50 cents, you can see it rebound. That could be a possible entry there. If it cracks the 10-day, though, it's got a ways to drop down to the 40-cent area. Mana could be one to keep an eye on. Bit of a triangle little EMA squeeze happening here between the 10 and the 50-day. We might see a pop out of that soon. OMG pushing back over $9 here. If it re-breaks 9, I think we'll see it up to 10 for another test. This will be the third test, and I would expect a breakout here. Rally, bouncing off that trend line. So if you got in Rally, nice job. It's up to 75 cents. Breakthrough 75 cents. We could easily see it up to 85, 90 cents. Scale starting to push back up towards that 50 cent area. Keep it on watch. If it can break 50 cents, that could start running. Solana having them power outages and some little bit of sketchy stuff, but the price action is still in this triangle here, and we're very close, just trying to get straight that out there, to a possible breakout or breakdown. If it breaks down, the 200's at 120, but if it gets a breakout here, we'll probably see it make new highs above 220, maybe up at 250. So that's all the coins I'm going to cover for today. Let's look at the news real quick. Anything interesting? We've got insider trading allegations on OpenSea. So that may be something to take a look at if you're into NFTs. I'm not that big into them yet. Or if you're a holder of OpenSea's token. I think they have a token, if I remember correctly. Coinbase applies to list crypto future product. We're getting closer and closer to crypto futures. And I don't think the government wants that, because that means that the U.S. will pretty much be adopting crypto in a small form as far as investments go. We'll see if that goes through. If anybody can get the crypto futures through, it's probably going to be Coinbase, as they have a lot of money. Okay, so there we go. Solana back online after a day in the dark. So if everything runs smooth for a little bit longer on Solana, then I would say we'll see it break out of that triangle. Other than that, right now the market's looking pretty good. I'm expecting Bitcoin to hit that 50,000. We break 50,000, the bull run is back on. We're out of the consolidation. If there's any coins that I'm not currently covering that you would like me to cover on a weekly basis, put it down in the comments below. And if you haven't yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you'll be notified when I put out these daily crypto updates. Appreciate everybody joining me as always. Stay safe out there. Until next time.